24th of August 2017.
This is a 12-year-old male, not neutered Shih Tzu. Now, the average lifespan of Shih Tzu, of course, depends on the health, especially the mouth, the skin, the body. If it's fully healthy, normally it lives up to 15. In Singapore, it's possible 15 to 18, it's possible, but then the eyes will be all cataract, can't see much. Okay, so now in this dog, I checked the heart really. The heart is actually in good condition. So I checked the heart. Heart rate is okay. Any coughing? No coughing, that's good. No coughing. So overall the heart and lungs are alright. So as far as anaesthetic is concerned, short anaesthetic is okay, about 15 minutes. Not say 1 hour. So for this, the old dogs, you just do short and surgeries maybe 3 times instead of 1 time. Now the surgery required for this dog will be dental, as you can see. The teeth are really full of tartar. The roots are exposed and it's quite painful. It's quite painful. So this one is the periodontal disease stage 4. That is one. Then the second one, we are talking about the important ones for the health. And the second one is this circum-anal. How long? 1 year, right?
Less than
1 year. So it's quite small. Now if the owner ignores it, the dog will lick it. That's why it's all bored. And then the blood will be on the floor. Sometimes it starts to spread and grows bigger until the whole area or goes upwards. So now it's quite easy to cut up actually. Just an electro surgery, zip, and then this one is easy, but not everyone is that easy. It doesn't involve the anus or the rectum. This is called circum-anal tumor. Now the reason, because this owner didn't sterilize the dog. Actually, we had sterilized the dog when he was young. 99% they don't get this, because it's probably due to the male hormones. And this circum-anal tumor happens only in old male dogs. They are not castrated. Now this dog has, we call it a retained testicle. You see there's only one. Now there's another one here below, under the skin. This one, you cannot see, but let's put it upside down. Upside down you can see. Okay, that is here. Now, lucky for the dog and the owner, it hasn't gone to a big, but it's growing already, you can see it's quite big. Now, it may be 3 or 4 years more, or 2 years more, if it's cancerous, it becomes as big as a duck's egg. And that one is all rotten, but I mean the cancer, testicular cancer. Now, this one is actually very common in Singapore, ringworm, you call it, because you can see ring. It starts with rashes first, and it has spread to the face as well. The face and the neck a bit, very little, and then below, let's see below is spread. So all the rings, at first was the rings, and then after they all join together and become one big black pigmented patch. This is due to the owner applying some cream or some spray. Now the original ringworm will be like this, a reddish color, you can see. This one, these are ringworms and bacteria and yeast. It's very itchy. This affects the whole body, there, including here. You see that this one, I think the owner didn't apply much spray, so it's still the red color. You see, these are all ringworm and yeast. Now, the yeast are okay. You see, but there's still some pigmentation. This shows that the dog has been scratching the ear, and then it just probably is painful. Right? You see, it's painful. Okay, because the owner applied some commercial ear drops, and it might have damaged the ear, lower ear. This one also painful. Right? You see, so some ear drops are not suitable for the dog. Okay, there's some pain, but not very serious. Now the main thing or the complaint from the owner of this dog had some pain somewhere around here. We can still walk and stand. So normally we check the disc, whether the dog has slip disc or not. So the check is just palpation. You see the reaction. But here it's not happy. But it's not serious, so I can't show exactly. But if it's very serious, the dog won't be standing. One more time. The dog looking backwards. Okay, so we know this dog either has fallen down on the back or jumped down from the steps. But it's not serious, so it's an early stage. Only recently, right? It's probably a recent thing, right? It's not been.
We didn't realize it.
It's not a long time.
We only feel that the stomach swollen is due to that.
Okay, the owner is worried about the stomach. There's quite a bit of a swelling here. Now, what's the cause? Now, whether it is water in the abdomen or not, you can see from here. From the side. You don't see from the top. It doesn't look so bad. But definitely there's some swelling here. Mm-hmm. I do abdominal palpation to see whether the liver is okay or not. Liver and spleen and kidney. Did the dog drink a lot of water?
That time.
No, not every day, right?
No.
So there's
certain
no
timing.
Not likely to be kidney or liver disease. But they drink a lot of water. And so this swelling is very possible that there might be something inside. But there's no pain. So it might be an abdominal tumour, some tumour inside. But for the time being, the dog is still eating well, right? Drinking, so we won't. I mean, if we want to find out, we need ultrasound. Do the ultrasound and then you show all the organs. Which one is swollen. Maybe some spleen. So now the best thing is a blood test. A blood test will show whether the liver and spleen, not liver and kidneys, are enlarged or infected. Then the other thing is, I've checked, there's no pain at all in the abdomen. How's the urine? The urine should be okay. Yeah?
Okay.
The pulse is strong and good.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
till you finish.
Loose stool,
so it could be intestinal, something wrong, tumor.
Loose stool, and then...